Okay. You guys asked for it. Oh, apparently we're having a son of a bitching rainstorm outside. What's in Dave's toolbox? Possibly the first and last episode. But we got to start with what's not in my toolbox. So, you know, this is what goes on. This is all sussed out. I got our rotary switch, and I'm waiting for pickups and a ground wire through the ass of that. I fabric cobbled a pick guard. I'm going to age that a little bit though. Need some testing for that. Okay, we're going to start with What's in Dave's Toolbox, episode 1/1.0, I don't know. And we'll begin with what's not in Dave's toolbox. Okay, so we're down in the bowels of tool land. And this is mostly my special effects stuff. We like these tools because they're small and we have to crawl around in weird places and do shit behind sets. And, you know, the big honking battery-operated tools aren't necessarily friendly when you're 30 feet on a ladder trying to drill a 1/8 of an inch hole for a wire to slip through. So that's part of my effects package. That's just bits and shits, some gloves. You can see, right? See how hard I work? Okay, next in the pile of what's not in Dave's toolbox. A lot of this shit would never be my daily kit. I would always have a trunk full. But if I'm just doing like a daily sort of technician show up and do what I'm asked job, that's my kit for special effects. The wrenches are shit, mainly because the good ones got stolen. Everything has to have your name engraved in it, and even then, guys will grind your name off of it and engrave theirs on top. That's pretty much it, you know. The all-important tools, and that's it. So, cart that around with you at work. And there's more. Like I said, depending on the job, I could take that other kit. And there's more. Like I was saying, everything's got my name all over it. And this will never open up with one hand. Hold on. Yeah, so this is another bag of heavy wrenches and pipe wrenches, depending on what we're doing for the day. I sort of have a heads up and know which bag to grab. And that would be one of them. And I'm telling you, it ain't fun to lug across the parking lot in the winter. Okay, now we're down into this, which is yet another bag. That's a whole big rigid set. Hammer, drill, skill saw, angle drill. The saw's all, someone liked it more than me and decided to steal it. I don't know why. Because you need all the charger and everything there, Rockhead. It probably got lost or just thrown in the garbage. I don't know. But this has been a good set. I've had this, oh geez, at least 15 years. Maybe a little more. Had to replace a few batteries, but other than that, and you can actually just rebuild those batteries if you have a brain. Okay, we're going to move up a shelf. In a minute. This isn't tools, it's just a shit box of guitar parts. The dog's breakfast, folks. And moving on yet to another bag of daily tools for special effects. I gotta pull this out. Depending on the other obstacles that have been tossed at us, this would be another bag of tools to rig, do, and make a special effect go. There's some pretty good stuff in here. But, you know, that's it. In my brain, I know exactly what's in here. And, you know, we'll talk about that. The ideology of owning tools. Yeah, and I'm back in here for one last bag of special effects bullshit, which I spilt most of it on the floor. This is just some drill bits and Sawzall shit. What's this other one? Oh, this is a bag of shit for pyrotechnics. Number roll, colored tapes, automatic wire strippers. Okay, we're out of that. I think I broke something. I think those are my shitty wire strippers. Let's just check. Did we break them? Oh, I don't see any pieces missing off of those. Okay, onward and upward. Next, more schwa's. You know, battery charger. This is a lot of touch-up stuff for, you know, that sort of thing. A little bit of glue. Bunch of shite back there, which I'm scared to look at. It's just polishes and, you know, my anonymous mask, which I haven't used for a while. I'll have to get back to that program. Okay, up one more. This is a shit show because I just throw things here. This is just shit. There's nothing here of any use. So, that's pretty much, you know, what's not in Dave's toolbox. Sorta. Hold on, we'll get to the toolbox. So, we're still looking at what's not in Dave's toolbox. Once again, the old Milwaukee, little skunky driver. Oh, look, I found those. See how it works? When we go there, and I know that I've kept those there, because my brain tells me. Uh-oh, that was a sneak peek at what's in Dave's toolbox. Okay, I gotta get rid of some of this shit. And we'll look at the top drawer. This is just a bucket of skeef. Household skeef, you know. I fix things here around the house, too. Some neck rests. Everybody was all freaked about seeing my address. Don't give a shit. I haven't lived there for 5 years. Have at it. Have fun. Okay. More parts to repairs I haven't completed, which are either for myself or for friends who don't care. Well, they care, but not much. A little bit of sandpaper, a fucking windy, and a piece of rubbery, and we're into drawer one. Top one, here we go. The big reveal, and I know it's going to be a big ass adjustable wrench. That's another special effect tool. I don't know why I got in there. Some impact sockets and a variety of other sockets. And what is that? Good find, Dave. Those are tips for your soldering iron. Why they're in there, I do not know. And the keys. Okay, that's the top. This is skeef. I never go in here. Haven't been in there in 100 years. Like I said, more derelict special effects tools. Believe it or not, I've had to use that a lot. Okay, closing that shitter down. And we'll move down to the Blame Canada drawer. And this is a bunch of hexy, some torquey stuff, some nut drivers, some other hex drivers. Oh, look, an air chuck, some punches, spring punches, tire chuck, more soldering tips, which I bought and I probably had them. See, they were under there, right? And I bought new ones, like an ass. Okay, back to the philosophy of owning tools. Let's talk about it. Okay, before I reveal the next drawer, just want to say, the t-shirt people who are excellent phoned me today, and I will be picking up a big boatload of shirts tomorrow And I'll be starting to get those out in the mail. So thank you to everybody. There's extra shirts. Don't hesitate to jump in and get a shirt. There will be shirts. If I don't have your size, well, the worst case Ontario is I give you a refund. Anyway, we went through the Blame Canada drawer. Now we're into the One Below YouTube drawer. That's all I tell people. It's in the drawer One Below YouTube. In the right-hand box. And if it's not there, look for the Toronto Chrysler drawer. Okay, anyway. This one, what do we got? A bunch of box wrenches. A couple paint can openers. Some socket drivers. That sort of shit. This don't use this much no more. There's nothing to take apart. Unless you build it yourself. Okay, I think one more drawer. I'm going to stop. Some ratcheting metric dog bones, which I don't think I have ever used. Maybe once. Oh, look. That's where that is. See? It's all good. Let's go one more drawer. Actually, we'll do the top toolbox, and then we'll save the others for another time. Okay, back to the philosophy of buying tools. And I've been yakking about this, but I'm going to say it now. If you are a person who has ever gone out and spent your hard-earned money on a tool, you will always remember in your brain that you have that tool. Where that tool is, that might screw up, but you know you had it. And you probably remember who you lent it to. And that's just the thing. Like, I'm just telling you, as you go out and buy tools one at a time, this is pretty much just a drawer of things that measure things. I don't know what's in that envelope. You know, the old school set, some dead rulers and a level, tape measures, layout square, on and on. Okay, that's the last drawer for today. I don't know what's in there. I think these are old decals for guitars. Anyway, I'm quitting. Okay, so thanks to everybody who got a shirt. Thanks to everybody who's got a sticker. There's more stickers coming. Shirts, just jump in. I really do appreciate it. And I think the War Amps appreciate it too. I got a couple tweets from them. They know what I'm doing. They dig it. And, you know, I just send them for more return address labels, and we can't beat that. Okay, so I guess episode 2 will be the lower hatch here. I don't think it'll be too exciting, so we might have to, you know, add a few doors. Anyway, cheers, folks. Thanks for all the support. Become a patron if you have not. Those that are patrons get it. You can bug me. You can ask me questions. I'll give you my phone number. You can call me up. I'll help you figure it out. It's that easy. Cheers.